Welcome back to Giro Bike Gear Guides, where we cover everything you need to start riding. I'm Hema, and today let's chat about what to wear on the bike. Cycling apparel might feel hard to get used to, but it's actually a key part of keeping your ride comfortable. Everything from how your bump feels on a ride to how well you can adapt to changes in the weather can be covered with a good cycling kit. I wasn't always an expert. When I started riding, I saw that everyone was wearing these tight kits and padded shorts, and I wanted to fit in, but I wasn't sure where to start. So I just bought some super tight, thin black bike shorts, and I'm talking about the shorts like the ones from the 80s, not the real padded cycling shorts. And after a couple of rides while I was dating my now husband, he took me aside and told me that my shorts were completely see-through in the back. And that's when I learned that not only do you need a short with a nice material that won't show anything you want to keep private, but also I learned the magic of padded shorts for protecting your seat bones. And now I'm here to make sure you don't make the same mistakes I did. So let's get started. First of all, there's no official uniform for riding a bike. Let's say that again. No matter what someone might try to make you feel, you can wear whatever you feel comfortable in to ride. Seriously, let's break down the options. Some riders like the sleek road racer look. Its minimal patterns are designed for maximum aerodynamics with no flapping materials. Others are fans of a more relaxed look favored by many mountain bikers. The designs may be boxier, but the fabrics are still high performance. There are also designs that fall in between the two and can even look great off the bike. Now your kit is almost complete, but have you planned for the weather? Remember that sometimes if you leave on a ride when it's sunny, it might be cold and windy at the top of a climb and vice versa. If you head out the door on a chilly early morning ride, it might be much warmer once the sun comes out. Accessories like jackets and vests are clutch for staying comfortable in variable weather, and so are gloves. Gloves can also have pads to absorb road vibrations or protection on the knuckles to fend off branches on overgrown trails. And gloves help you keep your grip on the handlebars if your palms get sweaty. Both outer layers and gloves can also feature various levels of protection against the cold and the wet. Last but not least, let's talk about padding I mentioned earlier. The padding in bike shorts is called chamois. It's pronounced chamois, but spelled totally different. Road shorts typically include a chamois, which can help make sitting on a bike saddle more comfortable, especially for long rides. Sometimes riders who like the baggy short look will use liner shorts with a chamois for the same reasons. Either way, you don't want to wear underwear if you choose a short with a chamois. They are designed to fit snug and reduce chafing, and there's no room for underwear. So you have lots of options. Although some styles might be more common on the road and others on the trail, it's all about your personal comfort. Most of these pieces are interchangeable and would work for you on any type of ride. Check back with Giro Bike Gear Guides for more tips and everything you need to know to start riding.